Oh. For the celebration of Holy Mass, please find the hymn I, the Lord of Sea and Sky. It's on page 3.
Is it?
stand. The entrance hymn is on page 6.
Your Eminence, Cardinal Vincent, Bishop Hesket, Archbishop Emeritus Paul, Bishop-elect Carmelo, Honourable Minister Vella, Honourable Minister from Gibraltar, all our friends from Gibraltar, welcome to this celebration. As we say in Maltese, Merhaba, ونشتين سلمو كل للهوتنا مالتين لجو بيش نطلبو فلمكين مع العزيز مسيو كارميلو زاميتو ويسي سوتشسور تالابوستلي بتأييد تاليدين تاليسفيت والطلبة تالكنيسيا ايو نطلبو فلمكين الكنيسيا في جبلتا الكنيسيا في مالتا بيش المولاي كومبلي زينا بالقدسية
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you. My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and prepare ourselves to celebrate together these sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Amen. Excelsis Deo.
Et in terramus hominibus quodae voluntatis.
La
O God, who by the singular gift of your untold grace have willed today to set your servant and priest Carmel over the Church of Gibraltar, grant that he may carry out worthily the office and ministry of bishop, and that under your constant governance he may direct by word and example the people entrusted to his care, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
L-ewwel qari mill-ktieb tal-profeta Iżajja. L-Ispirtu ta' Sidi l-Mulej fuqi, għax il-Mulej ikkonsagrani biex inwassal il-bxara t-tajba lill-fqajrin. Batni ndewwi l-qalb miksura biex inħabbar il-ħelsien lill-imjassrin u lill-ħabsin il-ftuħ tal-ħabs. Biex innidi s-sena tal-grazzja tal-Mulej u jum il-vendetta ta' Alla tagħna biex inferraċ lill-imni ktin, biex inferraħ lill-dawk li jikbu f'Sion, natihom kuruna flok irmiet, żejt tal-ferħ flok l-ilbis tal-vistu, lana tal-foħrija flok ruħ mitluqa. Il-kelma tal-Mulej.
Għataw flimkien il-verset ta' s-salm responsoriali, it-tieba tal-mulej irrid dejjem nanni.
David għaddej tijaj, bizzejtim għaddej tijaj dliktu. Tkuni dida jemmjow, un saħħu kol bidrijaj.
Flimkien.
Fedelta u t-tieba tiegħi. Bismi tissaħħaħ il-qawwa tiegħu. U jsejjaħli, int missieri u Alla tiegħi. Fortizza u salvazzjoni tiegħi.
Għarri mit-tieni ittra ta' San Pawl Apostlu lil Timotju. Aziz, infakrek biex tqajjem fik id-don ta' Alla li jinsab fik bit-tqejt ta' idejja. Għax Alla ma tanix spiritu ta' biża, imma spiritu ta' qawwa, ta' mħabba u ta' rażan. Mela tistħi xejn minħabba fix-xhieda għal sidna, anqas minħabba fija, priġunier tiegħu, imma aqsam miegħi t-tbatija l-Evanġelju u għafda fil-qawwa ta' Alla li salvana u sejħilna b'sejħa qaddisa. Mhux għax qies li mejjel tagħna, imma skont il-pjan tiegħu stess u skont il-grazzja tiegħu. Din il-grazzja tajjelna qabel iż-żmien tal-eternità fi Kristu Ġesu. Imma deret issa permezz tad-dera tas-Salvatur tagħna, Kristu Ġesu, li qeret il-mewt u dawwa lil-ħajja bla tmiem permezz tal-Evanġelju li għalih jien kont magħmul predikatur, apostlu u mgħallem. Din hi l-kawża li għalija qiegħed imbagħati, imma b'daqshekk ma nistħix għax jien naf minn hemm int u naf sewwa li hu jista' jħares it-teżor li kien fdat f'idejja sa ma jasal dak il-jum. Nżomm quddiem għajnejk l-eżempju tat-tagħlim sħiħ li smajt minn għandi fil-fidi u fl-imħabba li huma fi Kristu Ġesu. Ħares bil-għajnuna tal-Ispirtu Santu li jammar finna it-teżor sabiħ li kien fdat f'idejk il-kelma tal-mulej.
Kantaw fl-imkien.
Alleluja, alleluja, alleluja.
Man did not come to be served, but to serve and to give his life as a ransom for many.
From the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
In those days, Jesus said to his apostles, "You know that the rulers of the Gentiles lord it over them, and the high officials exercise authority over them. Not so with you. Instead, whoever wants to become great among you must be your servant, and whoever wants to be first must be your slave. Just as the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as a ransom for many."
The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Your Eminence, the Church of Gibraltar asks you to ordain this priest, Carmel Samit, to the responsibility of the episcopate.
And do you have a mandate from the Holy See?
We have.
Let it be read.
Francis, Bishop, servant of the servants of God. To our beloved son, Carmelo Samit, from the clergy of the Archdiocese of Malta, and up to this time judicial vicar, elected Bishop of the Diocese of Gibraltar, greetings and apostolic blessing. From this seat of Blessed Peter, we now turn our attention to one of the pillars of Hercules, arising majestically from the sea, today known as Gibraltar, where the beloved flock of the faithful are in need of a new bishop after the transfer of our venerable brother Ralph Heskett to the See of Hallam. Indeed, after having considered all the spiritual needs of the faithful who live in that promontory, we turn our eyes upon you, beloved son, adorned with outstanding gifts and ecclesiastical expertise, because of which we consider you capable of governing the same diocese. Having therefore considered the opinion of the Congregation for Bishops, with our apostolic authority, we appoint and declare you Bishop of Gibraltar, with the obligations and rights which pertain to your office and destination as they result from the sacred canons. We grant you the possibility of receiving episcopal ordination outside the city of Rome from any Catholic bishop according to the liturgical norms. But first, you are to admit your profession of faith and declare on oath your fidelity towards us and our successors according to the laws and norms of the Church. Furthermore, we wish that the clergy and people of your diocese be informed of our decree, and that they will freely recognize and accept you as their shepherd and herald of truth. Meanwhile, beloved son, while strongly recommending your ministry to the protection of your patron, Bernard of Clairvaux, with paternal solicitude, we advise you eagerly to share the Lord's mercies with your people, as a result of which your flock will praise God unceasingly and profess him as our Lord, as well as worshipping him as our eternal Father. Given in Rome at St. Peter's on the 24th day of the month of June, in the solemnity of the Nativity of St. John the Baptist, of the year of our Lord 2016, the Jubilee of Mercy, the fourth year of our pontificate, Francis.
Francesco is off. Addej tal-addejja ta' Alla. Lill-Iben Aziz tagħna Karmel Żamid, mill-kleru tal-Arċidjoċesi ta' Malta, sissa vigarju ġudizzjali, isqof elett tad-Djoċesi ta' Ġibilta, saħħa u barka apostolika. Minn din il-Kattedra ta' San Pietru nitfgħu l-attenzjoni tagħna lejn waħda mill-pliri ta' Erkole, tiela majestuża mill-baħar, illum marufa bħala Ġibilta. Fejn il-maħbuba ħutna fil-fidi jinħtieġu isqof ġdid, wara li l-venerabbli ħuna Ralph Heskett ġie msejjaħ biex ikun isqof tad-Djoċesi ta' Hallam. Għalhekk, wara li qisna l-ħtiġijiet spiritwali tal-merħla ta' ħutna fil-fidi li jgħixu f'dan il-promontorju, indawru l-ħarsa tagħna lejk, Iben maħbub tagħna, imżejjen botijiet żbieħ u b'esperjenza ekklesjastika kbira, li minħabba fihom inqisuk ħili li tmexxi lill-istess Djoċesi. Wara li smajna l-parir tal-Kongregazzjoni tal-Isqfijiet bis-seta' apostolika, naħtruk u niddikjarawk isqof ta' Ġibilta, bid-dmirijiet u drittijiet kollha marbutin ma' dan l-uffiċċju u ħatra kif joħorġu mill-kanoni qaddisa. Nagħtuk li tista' tirċievi l-ordinazzjoni barra l-Belt ta' Ruma mingħand isqof Kattoliku skont in-normi liturġiċi. Imma l-ewwel tkun għamilt il-professjoni tal-fidi u tkun ħadd il-ġurament tal-fedeltà lejna u lejn is-suċċessuri tagħna skont il-liġijiet u n-normi tal-Knisja. Barra minn dan aħna nixtieq ukoll li l-kleru u l-poplu tad-djoċesi tiegħek jiġu marfa bid-digriet tagħna u bliberta jarfuk u jilqawk bħala r-raj tagħhom u l-ħabbar tagħhom tal-verità. Sadattant eben Aziz tagħna, fil-waqt li nirrikmandaw il-Ministeru tiegħek lill-ħarsien ta' San Bernard ta' Clairvaux, bimħabba ta' missier inħeġġuk bil-ħerqa biex taqsam il-ħnina tal-mulej mal-poplu tiegħek. Biex il-merħla tiegħek tfaħħar bla waqfien lill-Alla, waqt li tistqarru bħala l-mulej tagħna u tqimu bħala il-missier etern tagħna. Moti f'Ruma minn San Pietru fl-24 jum tax-xahar ta' Ġunju. Solennità tat-twelli ta' San Ġwan Battista tas-sena tal-mulej 2016 ġublew tal-ħnina ir-raba' sena tal-pontifikat tagħna. Iffirmat Papa Franġisku.
Archbishop Charles, thank you very much for your invitation to me to come and celebrate this Episcopal ordination, and thank you very much for your words of welcome. It is for me a real pleasure and a privilege to be here and to learn a little of the riches of this island. I haven't been to its neighbor, Gozo, and also to have this opportunity of greeting people both here and in Gibraltar who are watching this ceremony on television. Thank you very much indeed. Now, at the heart of our ceremony today, there stands a very powerful prayer. We pray to God as Father of mercies and God of all consolation, and this is our prayer: to pour out upon this chosen one the power which is from you, the governing spirit whom you gave to your beloved Son Jesus Christ, the spirit given by him to the holy apostles who founded your church in every place, to be your temple for the unceasing glory and praise of your name. Now, in this prayer, we express our faith, not only in a loving Heavenly Father and in the power of the Holy Spirit, but also in his church, the Catholic Church, which stands in the line of the apostles from its beginning to this day. This prayer reaffirms our sense of purpose of the church in every place. It is that of giving glory and praise to God. Now today we make this prayer gathered from this community of Malta, from Gibraltar, from Great Britain, from different churches. We make this prayer in the company of our Blessed Lady, Mother of the Church, whose birthday we celebrate today. And in making this prayer, we ask of God a great and wonderful gift, that Monsignor Carmelo leave this cathedral a changed man, a man on whom has been bestowed the astonishing gift of becoming a bishop, a successor of the apostles, a man endowed with new power and authority, a man now bound to Christ more deeply than ever before. In my humble experience, ordination as a bishop brings with it a more radical change in life than even the change wrought by ordination as a priest. And so, Monsignor Carmelo, our prayers are both for you and with you today and always. Now, we have just heard words written by St. Paul to his beloved companion Timothy. To me, it's astonishing to think that the feet of this great apostle graced this island, maybe coming as close as a cave in nearby Rabat. I'm sure he looks down on us this moment with his powerful gaze and his prayer. And he speaks to us unambiguously. He speaks of this gift of God, given through the laying on of hands, as a summons to witness to Christ and to bear hardship willingly. And in this, we are to rely solely on the power of God, knowing that his grace comes to us freely, never because of anything we have done. So let's be clear. Being a bishop is not a promotion. It's not the consequence of success, but it's a gift, a calling, a new step on the pathway of holiness, given for God's own purpose and in his own grace. So being a bishop is not a new opportunity to put one's own plans into action. It is a call to serve. Yes, the grace for which we pray is the gift of a governing spirit. But it's the spirit of Jesus, and therefore the governance to which it gives rise must be that of Jesus. And in the gospel today, St. Matthew tells us exactly what that means. Governance in the name of Jesus has no trace of the patterns of this world's ways, lording it over them, making their authority felt. Rather, this governance is a primacy of service. Jesus said, "Anyone who wants to be first among you must be your slave." This is the governing spirit of episcopal office for which we pray today. Shortly, Monsignor Carmelo, you will make the promises of a bishop. They start with promises about your duties concerning faithful teaching and unity with our Holy Father, Pope Francis. But they are equally emphatic in duties towards the poor and to strangers and to all who are in need. With these promises, you undertake to seek out the sheep who stray and to gather them into the fold of the Lord. And these promises make clear that you will only be able to fulfill them in cooperation with the priests and deacons who share your ministry. So at this point, I would like to offer a particular greeting to those priests and people who have made the journey from Gibraltar to be with you as their new bishop. These are the ones whom you promised so solemnly to work with in close cooperation. You know, a favorite theme of Pope Francis is that of closeness. And he speaks of the closeness which must exist between a bishop and his priests. In a bishop, he says, a priest must feel he has a father. And then he continues, If we take this paternity away from priests, we cannot ask them to be fathers. And thus, he goes on, the sense of God's paternity is removed. The Son, he says, the Son's work is to touch human miseries, spiritual and corporal, closeness. The Father's work, to be a father, a bishop father. And in these words of Pope Francis, is your calling. Now, the Diocese of Gibraltar, to which you are now being called, is a remarkable place, as you know well. In its history, its tradition, its location, it is in many ways a microcosm of Europe, with all its dramas and dangers and opportunities. The most ancient name of Gibraltar, as we have heard, is Calpe, now found really only in its Latin motto. Yet I understand, coming from the Phoenicians, the first inhabitants. The name Gibraltar comes from Arabic sources, Jibel Tariq, and its history bears all the marks of long conflicts and changes of rulers. My own visit to Gibraltar left powerful impressions on me, impressions of being at the gateway of Europe, of being in a place where people of different histories have found ways of living together. Perhaps most powerfully demonstrated in the hidden Jewish cemetery on the south side of the rock, looking away from the hostilities to which those people were subjected. To be a bishop of such a place is, I believe, a privilege and a challenge. It's to be responsible for the frontier of Europe, a place where all that Europe strives to stand for is first met. The great Spanish writer Ortega y Gasset wrote that civilization consists above all in the will to live together. And that is what I found in Gibraltar. It's more important than ever for the church in Europe, and therefore in Gibraltar, to proclaim and practice those values and qualities that lie at the heart of European civilization. These are truly fundamental values, values that underpin derived values such as democracy and individual freedom and the rule of law and tolerance, important as they are. But we must live and proclaim deeper values, the inalienable dignity of the person from conception to natural death, the equality in dignity of every person, the freedom to live and seek truth and love. And flowering from these values come the duties of accountability, the importance of deferring pleasure, the readiness to serve, and a sense of vocation in life that goes beyond profit and earthly inheritance. Now, these values which sustain our Europe of today, they are not freestanding. They are not self-evident or self-justifying. They derive from their Judeo-Christian roots, and they will be sustained only within the contexts of our beliefs, beliefs about the human nature, beliefs about the purpose of life and society. It is our task to proclaim them, and in doing so, to remember other words of Ortega y Gasset, that hatred is the one feeling which leads to the extinction of these values. A highlight of my brief visit to Gibraltar was to go to the shrine of Our Lady of Europe, standing literally on the edge of the continent, and recently having celebrated its 700th anniversary. Today we pray for her maternal intercession, that this precious continent of Europe and its heritage, to which we are all committed, may not lose its way or cease to live by its finest values. We pray that our witness and the witness of this new bishop will draw many to Christ, in whom is the fullness of our humanity, and who alone can save us from our fears and from the contradictions within us. May Our Lady of Europe bless this son of Malta as he makes his journey to his new home. He's been called to the mouth of this Mediterranean Sea, whose waters carry day by day both such tragic loss of life and heroic generosity of service. May Our Blessed Lady bless your episcopal ministry and strengthen us all to fashion anew our witness to the gospel and to the peace which is its gift, in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. And now let us proceed with this ordination. The ancient rule of the Holy Fathers ordains that a bishop elect is to be questioned in the presence of the people on his resolve to uphold the faith and to discharge his duty. And so, dear brother, do you resolve by the grace of the Holy Spirit to discharge unto death the office entrusted to us by the apostles, which we are about to pass on to you by the laying on of our hands?
I do.
And do you resolve to preach the gospel of Christ with constancy and fidelity?
I do.
And do you resolve to guard the deposit of faith entire and incorrupt, as handed down by the apostles and as preserved in the church everywhere and at all times?
I do.
And do you resolve to build up the body of Christ, his church, and to remain in the unity of that body, together with the order of bishops, under the authority of the successor of St. Peter the Apostle?
I do.
And do you resolve to render obedience faithfully to the successor of the blessed Apostle Peter?
I do.
And do you resolve to guide the holy people of God in the way of salvation as a devoted father, and to sustain them with the help of your fellow ministers, the priests and deacons?
I do.
And do you resolve, for the sake of the Lord's name, to be welcoming and merciful to the poor, to strangers, and to all who are in need?
I do.
And do you resolve, as a good shepherd, to seek out the sheep who stray and gather them into the Lord's fold?
I do.
And do you resolve to pray without ceasing to Almighty God for the holy people, and to carry out the office of high priest without reproach?
I do, with the help of God.
May God, who has begun this good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. Amen. Dearly beloved, let us pray that the kindness of Almighty God in providing for the welfare of the Church will grant an abundance of grace for this chosen one.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Kyrie eleison. Maria Mater Dei,
ora pro nobis.
Sancte Michael,
ora pro nobis.
Sancti Angeli Dei, Sancte Ioannes Baptista,
ora pro nobis.
Sancte Iosef,
ora pro nobis.
Sancte Petre,
ora pro nobis.
Sancte Paule, Sancte Andrea,
ora pro nobis.
Sancte Jacobe,
ora pro nobis.
Sancte Johannes,
ora pro nobis.
Sancte Thomas, Sancte Jacobe,
ora pro nobis.
Sancte Philippe,
ora pro nobis.
Sancte Bartolome,
ora pro nobis.
Sancte Matte, Sancte Simon,
ora pro nobis.
Sancte Taddee,
ora pro nobis.
Sancte Mattia,
ora pro nobis.
Sancta Maria Magdalena, Sancte Stefane,
ora pro nobis.
Sancte Ignazi Antiochene,
ora pro nobis.
Sancte Laurenzi,
ora pro nobis.
Sancte Perpetua et Felice,
ora pro nobis.
Sancta Agnes.
Ora pro nobis.
Sancte Gregori.
Ora pro nobis.
Sancte Augustine.
Ora pro nobis.
Sancte Athanasii. Basili.
Ora pro nobis.
Sancte Martine.
Ora pro nobis.
Sancte Benedicte.
Ora pro nobis.
Sancti Francisce Dominice. Sancte Ioannes Maria,
ora pro nobis.
Sancte Georgi,
ora pro nobis.
Sancte Publi,
ora pro nobis.
Sancta Catarina. Sancta Theresia Jesu,
ora pro nobis.
Beate Ignazi,
ora pro nobis.
Beata Deodata,
ora pro nobis.
Omnes sancti et sancte Dei,
ora te pro nobis.
Propitius est. Resurrectionem tuam.
Libera nos Domine.
Per effusionem Spiritus Sancti.
Libera nos Domine.
Ecclesiam tuam sanctam regere et conservare dinieris. Ut Dominum apostolicum et omnes ecclesiasticos ordines in sancta religione conservare dinieris. Tunc electum benedicere dinieris.
Te locamus aminos.
electum benedicere et sanctificare dignieris.
Te rogamus, Dominus.
Utunc electum benedicere et sanctificare et consecrare dignieris. Cunctis populis pacem et veram concordiam donare dignieris.
Te rogamus, Dominus.
Ut omnibus in tribulatione versantibus misericordiam tuam largiri dignieris. Nos met ipsos in tuo sancto servitio confortare et conservare dignieris.
Te rogamus, Dominus.
Iesu Fili Dei,
graciously hear our petitions, O Lord, and pour out upon this servant of yours the power of your blessing, flowing from the horn of priestly grace, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ,
Father of mercies and God of all consolation, God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, Father of mercies and God of all consolation, who dwell on high and look upon the lowly, who know all things before they come to be, and who laid down observances in your church through the word of your grace, who from the beginning foreordained a nation of the just born of Abraham, and who did not leave your sanctuary without ministers, and who from the foundation of the world were pleased to be glorified in those you have chosen. Pour out now upon this chosen one the power which is from you, the spirit of governance, whom you gave to your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, the spirit whom he bestowed upon the holy apostles, who established the church in each place as your sanctuary, for the glory and unceasing praise of your name. Grant, O Father, knower of all hearts, that this your servant, whom you have chosen for the office of bishop, may shepherd your holy flock, serving you night and day. May he fulfill before you without reproach the ministry of the high priesthood, so that, always gaining your favor, he may offer up the gifts of your holy church. Grant that by the power of the Spirit of the high priesthood, he may have the power to forgive sins according to your command, assign offices according to your decree, and loose every bond according to the power given by you to the apostles. May he please you by his meekness and purity of heart, presenting a fragrant offering to you through your Son, Jesus Christ, through whom glory and power and honor are yours with the Holy Spirit in the Holy Church, now and forever and ever. Amen. May God, who made you a sharer of the high priesthood of Christ, himself pour upon you the oil of mystical anointing and make you fruitful with an abundance of spiritual blessings. Receive the gospel and preach the word of God with all patience and sound teaching. Receive this ring, the seal of fidelity, adorned with undefiled faith. Preserve unblemished the bride of God, the Holy Church. Receive the mitre. May the splendor of holiness shine forth in you, so that when the chief shepherd appears, you may deserve to receive from him an unfading crown of glory. Receive the crozier, the sign of your pastoral office, and keep watch over the whole flock in which the Holy Spirit has placed you as bishop to govern the Church of God.
Thank you.
Pray now, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Let the offering we make, O Lord, for your church and for Carmel, your servant and bishop, be a gift acceptable to you, and for the benefit of his flock, endow with apostolic virtues him whom you have raised up as high priest among your people, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and fitting, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. By the anointing of the Holy Spirit, you made your only begotten Son High Priest of the new and eternal covenant. And by your ineffable plan, you were pleased to ordain to his one priesthood that his one priesthood should continue in the church. For Christ not only accords the dignity of a royal priesthood to the people he has made his own, but he also chooses men with a brother's care to receive a share in his sacred ministry by the laying on of hands. He chooses them to renew in his name the sacrifice of mankind's redemption, and to set before your family the Paschal meal, to lead your holy people in charity, to nourish them with your word, and to renew them through the sacraments. As they offer their lives for you and for the salvation of their brothers and sisters, they are to strive to be conformed to the image of Christ himself, and to offer you their constant witness of faith and love. And so, Lord, we all join the angels and saints in the joyous hymn of your praise.
Oh,
indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make us an everlasting offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Bernard, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, me, your unworthy servant, and Carmel, your servant, ordained today as a pastor of the church, with the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own.
Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed Salvatore Maria Concetta, parents of Bishop Carmel, to our brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
And now, at our Saviour's command, and formed by divine teaching, we now dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever. Amen. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Amen.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Page 59.
Oh.
Let us pray. By the power of this sacrament, Lord, multiply your gifts of grace in Carmel, your servant and bishop, that he may worthily fulfill before you his ministry as pastor and receive the eternal reward that you bestow on your faithful servants through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
After such a long ceremony, I don't think I should take too much time. And the only thing I would like to say to finish off this beautiful ceremony is, first of all, a big thank you to His Eminence, Cardinal Nichols, for accepting so readily to come here and to be the principal celebrant in this ordination. I'm sure that Cardinal Nichols will be one of the main helping hands I will have in Gibraltar. I'm sure of that. He is always interested in what goes on in Gibraltar. He came once, he loved Gibraltar, and I hope that in the future, soon in the future, he'll have another visit there. I also would like to thank the former bishop in Gibraltar, Bishop Heskett. He spent 4 years in Gibraltar, and I can say that the people in Gibraltar still show great affection towards him. My Archbishop, Charles Giucci Cluna, I thank him for all the trust he showed in me during the time he was Auxiliary Bishop and now as Archbishop. He was the first one, when I was nominated as bishop, to lend a helping hand. I went to him, I said, look, I have been the nominated bishop, I don't even know what I have to do. What do I have to do? And he started helping me. I said, what about the coat of arms? He said, well, leave that in my hands, immediately. And later somebody told me he is very much interested, he is one who likes heraldry, and in one afternoon he presented me with my coat of arms. I thank the Charge d'Affaires in the Nunciature, Monsignor Simon. He helped also in the process, and by his presence here we can say that we have the Pope with us, because he is the representative of Pope Francis, and so his presence gives, in a way, unity to what we are celebrating here with the whole Church. I really appreciate the presence of the dignitaries here. The Chief Minister wanted to come, I know that, with his wife, but something has cropped up and he sent Samantha Sacramento to represent him. I thank the government of Gibraltar, who, on behalf of the people of Gibraltar, donated the crozier
that you have seen in my hands. It's a beautiful crozier, and I'll treasure it all my life. I thank George Vella, who is representing the Prime Minister, and all the members of Parliament and dignitaries on the side of the government and on the side of the opposition. Now I'll say a few words in Maltese, if you permit me. Irrit fl-aħħar nirringrazzja l-ewwel nett lilkom il-koll li ġejtu għaw biħġarkom. Onestament ma stennejx tant nies. U meta ġejt u rajt il-katedral mimli, kont ferħan u sorpriż. Nirringrazzjakom il-koll. Nirringrazzja l-ewwel qabel kollox lill-familjari tiegħi, illi huma numerużi ħafna kif taraw. U waħda mir-raġunijiet għaliex għamilt iċ-ċelebrazzjoni hawn mhux ġibilta kienet illi ridt lill-familjari jkunu preżenti. Nirringrazzja lis-saċerdoti illi naqdu miegħi illum f'din iċ-ċelebrazzjoni. Mod speċjali nirringrazzja lill-kanonku Jesmont Manikaro u lill-Father Michael illi biex ngħidlek għamlu kollox għalija u m'organizzaw din iċ-ċerimonja kollha u attivitijiet li kelli. Mingħajrhom kont nintilef u verament ħassejt paċi matul il-preparazzjonijiet għax kont naf li qiegħed f'idejn tajbin. I would like to thank in a special way the priests of Gibraltar. There are 8 priests in Gibraltar at the moment. We have 8 priests with us here. 2 came from other parts. There is one from Spain who works in Spain, Father John, and there's another one who is in the forces. 2 stayed behind, but I told them from the beginning that I wanted the priests to be present, and I appreciate a lot that they made the effort and they came here. And also the group who came from Gibraltar to represent Gibraltar. Coming from Gibraltar to Malta is no easy task. Now I'm used to it, but those who are not used to it find it hard going because they have to get to flights. And that's not always easy. So just to conclude, when the nuncio called me to tell me about the Pope's wish that I become the Bishop of Gibraltar, I accepted with a sense of humility, and I also told the nuncio that with God's grace and the help of Our Lady, I'm sure that I can do my best to bring the Church in Gibraltar forward, to lead the Church in Gibraltar. His Eminence told us what a bishop, what his duties are, and the booklet that was prepared, I have to keep that, and from time to time read it, because that reminds me of all my duties. Most of you know that I spent about 20 years in Gibraltar, and 20 years also here, and that was another reason why I wanted to celebrate the ordination here, and later on we'll have the installation in Gibraltar. Gibraltar is a lovely place, and I love it. The people are very kind, they are generous, and they love their priests. And that's what makes me love Gibraltar so much. So in a way I can say that I'm going back home, from home to home. I consider Gibraltar and Malta both my homes. I would like to end by thanking my parents for all they did for us. Both of them died about 20 years ago, but I am sure that they'll be happy looking from heaven on us today. I commit myself also to the intercession of Our Lady of Europe. I come from a village where we have three big feasts for Our Lady. The cathedral in Gibraltar is dedicated to Our Lady. Our Lady of Europe is the patron saint also of Gibraltar. So I'm under good guidance. I'm sure that she will lead me in my office that the Pope has entrusted to me. The last word, now I invite everybody, after we finish, to go to Palazzo de Piro next door, where there will be a reception. Nishtiq nistieden il-kulħadd biex wara ċ-ċelebrazzjoni morru id-dar de Piro, palazz ħdej il-katedral, eżatt. Naħseb illi kulħadd għandu laċ u l-ġuħ, hemmhekk għejnuni biex dak li ġi preparat jispiċċa. Grazzi.
And now we stand for the final blessing. The Lord be with you. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Our help is in the name of the Lord. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Yeah.